Live from Highline Community College, it's another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun. This question sent in by Tina over there. Tina has this data and she is trying to use remove duplicates, but only wants to remove it if the first two elements between the commas are duplicate. So red upper, this one goes away. Yellow down, that one's unique, this one goes away. Mike has a formula. Mike is a smart guy. Mike has a formula to solve this. Should you go first?
I have a ridiculous formula.
Yeah.
I'm hoping you have some sweet and easy way.
I gotta see that formula first, because I can't imagine any formula that's gonna do that.
Yeah, but
it can't be done.
No.
There's no formula that will do that.
Except for I learned the concepts from this place called the Mr. Excel Message
Which
Board.
Is a great place. There's a lot of smart people there. There's no formula. This is pointless. We're wasting our time. Mike, there's no formula that will solve this.
Except for I'm sure you have an easy formula there. All right, when I look at this, the only way, and I've seen this problem before and even posted the Mr. Excel message board, if I have to get a second column, a comma, I don't know how to do that except for to insert a different character there. So how about I'm going to use the substitute. Substitute, I'm going to take this text, comma, the old text, that's what I want to find, comma. The new text I want to insert is this little bar. And the instance is 2.
Oh, sweet. Oh, look at that. Look at that. That's hot. Okay, go ahead.
All right, so.
Oh, that's cool.
Now, once I have that, I'm going to have to use this twice, because now I can say, find that character and take the leftmost. So I can go copy this, and I'm going to find the position first with search. Notice I just copied that substitute. I'm going to say search. I always use search instead of find if it's not case sensitive, because all you have to do is hit S tab. Find that text within there. Right, that gives me the position. I want to subtract 1, actually. And then I'm going to say the left. Now, I told you this is going to get ridiculous. The left of what? Control V, that substitute thing, comma, and that's how many characters from the left. All right, so now I have that, and I can say on that column, count if, and I'm going to take that range, colon, comma, left arrow, close parentheses. I'm going to make an expandable range, so F4, so as I copy this down, it'll be counting. Anytime it's greater than 1, I want to say true, so I'm going to change this to a logical formula. Now that's kind of ridiculous. I'd have to put text 2 and then true slash false, right, with some headers and then sort and delete. I actually could probably make a single cell formula, but that's sort.
So go back. That's in the true false, you don't have filter by selection in your quick access toolbar? Why don't you just filter by selection to all the trues? So right here, right? Uh-huh. Right click. Filter to selected cells value, and then delete the whole thing. Just delete those rows. Edit delete. Because it only will delete the visible ones, right?
You mean like this?
I hope so.
I think that the way I would do it is, I forgot the keyboard trick.
Alt-EDR.
So it's like.
But not the heading.
There is a keyboard shortcut for visible cells only.
It's you don't have to do that, though. Just try it. We'll undo it if it doesn't
work. Alt what?
So here, do this. Select these. Alt-EDR. Alt-EDR. Yes. And then turn off the filter.
Just Control-Shift-L.
There we go, and everything that's left.
Absolutely
so when
beautiful.
You filter and delete, it doesn't delete the hidden rows.
Is amazing.
All right, now wait. Okay, so that formula makes my head spin, like all of Mike's formulas make my head spin. I think Tina comes here with this problem, and I say, Tina, I'm going to have to knock out a really hard formula here. I need absolute silence, so you need to go away. Go downstairs and buy me a Coke. And by the time you get back, I'll have this formula working. And then I will, Tina's not here watching me do this, I would do Alt DE, text to columns, delimited by a comma. Click finish. Undo. Alt DE, delimited by a comma. In step three, though, I want it to go to column B. Right? So I'm going to make all those words split out over there. And I'm going to add my little head one, heading one. I'm going to grab the fill handle and drag across. And the amazing thing about remove duplicates, so control asterisk, remove duplicates out here is pretty hot. Most people don't realize that it will look at two columns. So I'm going to unselect all, choose head one, head two, click OK. And it got rid of the ones where both heading 1 concatenated with heading 2 was the same as something else. And then at that point, I can just delete all this stuff out here. And
is that not totally awesome?
Sweat on my brow when Tina comes back. I say, that was the hardest formula. You wouldn't believe it. I had to go to Mike Girvin to figure out what the answer was.
And I had to go to Mr. Excel, Bill Jelen, to get the easy way.
This is cool. This is wild. You know, Mike, I have to thank Mike. Mike comes up with most of these problems for the Dueling Excel podcast. I think I've come up with 2 out of the 102. But we rolled in here today, and he thought I was going to come up with hard stuff. And that's the great thing. Everyone has a different way to solve things in Excel.
Woohoo! Right. Absolutely beautiful.
Well, hey, that was our, was that 101? 102.
102,
episode 102.
It's already 102 in the morning?
Yeah, it feels like it, actually, yeah. Well, hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel and
Excel is fun.
All right.